The leading Team Canada as they get set to compete in the Tokyo Games themselves. We're talking about basketball player Miranda Ayim and rugby player Nathan Hirayama. A huge honor for the two, and also a nod to gender parity as Canada is naming two athletes this time around, one man, one woman, to carry the flag. And of course, we're going to continue to cover reaction to this news throughout this day. But we're also going to keep talking about the choice and bring into the program right now Olympian Mark Tewksbury. Mark, nice to see you. I say Olympian, but also former chef de mission himself, currently vice president with the board of directors with the COC. Good to see you, Mark. It's been too long. Let's talk about the choice and the announcement today. What do you make of Miranda Ayim as well as Nathan Hirayama?
Oh, great choices. A really interesting departure from traditional sort of approach to this. You know, usually we sort of don't go for star power for a well-known athlete typically, but I really like this choice. I like it because teams are such a important part of the Tokyo 2020 team. So Miranda was with me in London in 2012. And at that time, we had two team sports. We had soccer and basketball. Soccer, of course, never stayed in the village. They toured around England until they finally got to the bronze medal game. But the basketball team stayed with Team Canada the entire time in the Olympic Village. And I can't tell you how important they were to create that team feeling within the bigger team of Team Canada. So to honor two team sport athletes, I think, was a fantastic choice.
Well, you know, I want to pick up on that point because, as you say, Olympian, former chef de mission, how important are the flag bearers for Team Canada? Do they, can they serve as inspiration and competition for other Canadians to reach for gold?
I like to think it sets the tone for Team Canada. So, you know, Simon Whitfield carried the flag, but we also had Ian Miller walk between Sylvie Bernier and I as chef and assistant chef, representing the 10-time Olympian, the iconic legend that he was, and that history walking in front of the rest of the athletes, kind of walking them into their first Olympics or second Olympics, if you will. So there's a bit of ceremony and representation and sort of ideas that the chef and the selection committee will have on why they choose who they choose. Each sport puts forward a nomination, so there's a great list of candidates. It's always really tricky. There's some very worthy candidates, but I certainly like where this landed very much. Gender equity, two team sports, diverse candidates. I think it's a great decision for where we are in this moment in time.
Well, let's talk about gender equity. You know, Tokyo 2020, it will be the first gender balanced Olympic Games in history, the first to allow joint flag bearers from any country, both male and female, to come down with their national flags. So talk to us about the movement now being made to have gender equity reflected, particularly when you think about Team Canada, considering how the women have really carried the team in the past few games.
Listen, we are women-led. We were more women than men in Rio. I think we are again here. So Canada is very much gender equity. But I think it's important for the movement as a whole. You know, like many, many businesses, the higher get up in the power structure, the less gender diversity and equity we have. So I think it's really important. Let's at least get it right at the athlete level. And hopefully we can push some change also at the international sport leadership level.